Back on Cuse TV, Jordan Evans joining us now. And Jordan, you've scored here in each of the last couple games at a nice goal down in Carolina. Are you finally starting to feel like you're getting into the rhythm that you hoped you'd really be in from last year on?
Yeah, I definitely think that after the Albany game and being able to produce a couple points, definitely got my confidence back, got back into the swing of things and felt more comfortable out there, more back to where I thought I would have been at this point in the season. So it was definitely a good turnaround.
How have you had to battle just avoiding frustration here for the last couple years where you've had it all set up for success and really it's only been injuries holding you back?
Yeah, it's pretty difficult, especially mentally with the injuries happening. But, I mean, all I can do at this point is push forward, and getting past this injury and having it not nag me the entire season is a great news and a great thing for me. So I guess I just got to take it forward and just expect that it's going to go great from here on out.
What's it been like trying to build chemistry here on the second midfield line? Because, you know, Tim was up on attack there for a few weeks, and now he's back down with you guys.
I think our chemistry definitely comes in practice. I think we have enough guys that slide in down at attack every practice anyways. I mean, whether Randy's there or not, we have multiple guys moving in and out. So Tim, me, and Weston have been together pretty much the entire season. And I think we're coming together quite good now. I mean, the Albany game was definitely a good turnaround for us. I mean, but if we can keep producing and taking advantage of the short sticks and what the defense gives us, and take a little bit of pressure off the first line and some of the attackmen that are being covered by some of their better defenders, I think it's definitely helping out a lot.
And I guess there has to be that chemistry going across the lines, right? We saw Henry get banged up last game, and it really was sort of mixing and matching the rest of the way.
Yeah, I mean, I think anybody at any point can step up and fill any position. I think we have multiple guys that are former attackmen. We have multiple guys that can play midfield at the same time. So, I mean, at this point, if anybody goes on, I think we really have multiple guys that can step in and fill their shoes.
Tell us your view of the season as a whole right now. Yeah, there's a couple losses, but they're to the current number one and current number two. Does that give you confidence going forward that you've been right there with everyone and those are just losses on the road?
Yeah, I think that those two losses, I mean, we have, I don't know if we have a ton to learn from. I think that we have little things that we could fix and tweak and come out with those victories. But I think that that's great news that we were right there. I mean, and we just, I mean, maybe didn't have a great first quarter or a great shooting performance. And if that had turned around the other way, we may have come out on top of those games. So, and I think that it's good that we know that we're going to meet these teams in the ACC tournament no matter what in the end. So, I mean, those losses earlier in the season maybe don't mean as much at this point.
All right, that's coming up in a little less than 2 weeks. You got the one game between then, it's Hobart, which has been a big rivalry for years. What's your view of this rivalry between Syracuse and Hobart?
I mean, it goes back years. I mean, the Cross Simmons Trophy, definitely want to keep it in Syracuse. I mean, we've heard a lot of the stories about it and all the coaches and all the people behind it. So I think that is motivation enough to keep it going, keep it here. I think that you can't take anybody lightly. I think Hobart's a great team, no matter what their record shows. And I think we're definitely going to have to play as hard as we can and act like it's any other game.
Yeah, it was 2 years ago before you got here that Hobart won the game. And there's a lot of guys on this team that have to remember that.
Yeah, I mean, they always have a great team. They always have guys that are, I mean, they have great attackmen. They have great defense. And I think that, just like I said, you can't take anybody lightly. You can't look past this game to the ACC tournament. We got to take care of business here first.
All right, Jordan, good to see you out there and healthy, and good luck tomorrow.
Thank you very much.